I'm Cal Herron. I'm Nevada King Gold's project manager. I'm currently out here at the Atlanta mine. We just announced results from our latest drilling at Atlanta. HG21, which was put at the southwest end of the pit, cut a little over 70 meters at 3.18 grams per ton gold and 20.8 grams per ton silver. The hole is notable also because it has a high-grade interval in it, about 15 meters, grading 6.63 grams per ton gold and 68.6 grams per ton silver. This is a fairly high-grade hit. It's important because it's next to another high-grade hole, HG13, about 25 meters away. That hole cut 82.3 meters, grading 3.6 grams per ton gold, with a high-grade interval of 12 meters, grading 17.6 grams per ton. That's the highest grade of anything that's been hit historically or currently on this end of the property. So this was an eye-opener to hit grades like this. We are currently offset both of these holes to the north, south, and further to the west to try to ascertain the dimensions of the high-grade zone. These holes basically were put along the what we call the West Atlanta Fault, which is shaping up to be a major feeder or hydrothermal flue, which fed gold and silver-bearing fluids into the stratigraphy that hosts the gold in Atlanta. The West Atlanta Fault is a major structural break, which controlled not just gold mineralization, but also shallow intrusive activity, which seems to be genetically related to the gold mineralization. This zone is at least 400 meters long, and we don't know how far to the north it goes, and we don't know how far to the south it goes either. There's been no drilling to the south, and there hasn't been really any drilling to the north. So we will be following this major structural zone over the coming months with some detailed fence drilling in order to get a better handle on the actual grades and thicknesses of gold mineralization, which is basically runs right down the middle of the resource zone. So this is a very strategic location. It's important to get a high-grade core going on this project where you can take these high grades and move them laterally into the low grades that flank the main structures. And this is what will allow eventually for a much larger resource. And this was part of the problem that Ken Ross and Etta Bay had years ago. They did not find enough high-grade material in the western part of the deposit to really justify trying to mine it. They were stuck at 500,000 ounces, and the project really wasn't going any further. With the detailed drilling we're doing now, we're hitting these high-grade structures that Ken Ross and Meadow Bay largely missed. I say largely missed because their holes were fairly wide spaced. Plus, many of the holes did not even get into the mineralization. They didn't go deep enough. So there were numerous gaps in the historical data, which gave us glimmers of high grade. So we knew there was some high grade out there, but there wasn't enough hole density, especially holes that went deep enough. And that's the big change here. This is what Nevada King has done in the last 6 to 7 months, is with our drill forays out into the western part of the deposit, we are now hitting and better defining these high grade core structures. So that's what has us excited. We find high grade where it wasn't really known of before. And that changes how you look at the entire property. This is the type of progress which we feel is going to potentially impact both the resource and the mine economics.